Okay, so we are going to start where we left off. Xelha was kidnapped, and now we're supposed to go into clear the path to Perkad, but there's some crystallized magnus and stuff back here that I wanted to get before heading forward. You always want to make sure and get these. Sometimes they don't have anything good, but more often than not, they have something worth going back for. I'm highly considering playing the prequel to this game, though it was made after this game. It's number two to this series, but it's a prequel. So it happens like 18, 20 years before this game, or the time period in this game. So I've really considered doing it. I think it would be fun.
Don't be thinking you can beat me.
Don't forget to come back to this guy with the bracelet. It's very important that you remember everyone that has a bracelet. It's going to be really interesting whenever your card deck gets really big and you're able to put down a whole bunch of cards.
Don't be thinking you can
beat
me.
Not just two.
That was way too easy.
Dead. We'll go and kill these. I know it's very little experience, but meh, we should get some good cards.
Don't be thinking you can beat me! Let's get it on.
This. Yeah. Nice. I like getting this straight. Okay, probably go to town and rest our wings, try to sell some stuff, and then we'll head to the valley. Rest our wings, and that'll heal us completely up. I think I'm gonna switch out belt buckles. Yeah, that was a good choice. It's really only the equipment you have, you can't change anything else but that.
cheeseburger!
You've attained a Magnus Frozen Shield. Will come in handy.
Time to party! Loser.
Will you look at this rubble blocking the path? Just my luck that I decided to risk my life and there's a landslide. If only I had some explosives. Then I could clear a path. What am I saying? Fat chance of finding explosive out here in the sticks. A pile of massive rocks is blocking the path. They are too heavy to move. Looks like we can't go any further. If we could just blow the suckers to bits, then we wouldn't need to move. Heaven's names, did you find explosives? Are you from the Empire or something?
Don't be thinking you can beat me. Thank you. time for messing around. Like the odds here. Battle.
there's a crystallized Magnus in there. Got a secret recipe. Man with the bracelet, so we remember that we need to keep track of everyone that has a bracelet. I'm standing under this waterfall as part of my training, plus it's part of my Flab Smasher diet plan. Training every day is the best way to build up your body. You should give it a try. Right bananas could do damage, but if they've been in your deck long enough, right bananas turn into regular bananas, and regular bananas can kill you.
Storm.
in there for a second.
The enemies in this area aren't challenging enough for me. I can't get motivated to fight. Well, my success is to be expected since I'm privy to the secrets of combat. Are you interested in hearing the secrets? I'll tell you some of what I know. You've made it this far on your journey, so you've probably seen a prize or two during one of your battles. Located on the upper right corner of each Magnus card, you'll see a number. This number is the card's spirit number. The amount of damage you inflict on enemies changes based on the combination of the spirit number in your hand. Certain combinations of spirit numbers in a hand give you a bonus called a prize. There are two types of prizes, straight and pair. A straight occurs when the spirit numbers in your hand are in order. A straight will give you a bigger bonus than a pair. Both descending and ascending orders are okay. If all the spirit numbers in your hand are in a straight order, a straight will occur. A pair occurs when all the spirit numbers in your hand can be paired with another card in your hand. If there's even a single card in your hand that cannot be paired, you won't get the pair of prize. The order of the spirit numbers in your hand are not taken into consideration. Just make sure that all your cards can be paired with another. Pairs are easier to get than straights and give you a smaller bonus. If your deck becomes empty during your offensive turn, a deck shuffle must occur. In this case, your turn will be skipped because there's no card that can be drawn. All Magnus cards, including any powerful ones in your current hand, will be shuffled. It's advisable to use as many Magnus as possible before a deck shuffle occurs. A deck shuffle can only occur during your offensive turn. If you notice a deck shuffle during your defensive turn, adapt your strategy accordingly. Any Magnus that you use during your defensive turn is regarded as having been used on yourself. If poisoned, use a Magnus with the antidote attribute and your condition will be cured. Use your defensive turn wisely and you will be able to cure your conditions without using an offensive turn. However, remember that if you use a poison-inflicting Magnus during defense, you'll become poisoned. Sometimes you may even find yourself confused as to whether your turn is defensive or offensive. If this is the case, listen carefully. Let your ears guide you. Eventually, your body will be able to distinguish and react just to the sound. Once this happens, you've become a master like me. Okay. made it to Perkad. Now I'm going to take a break, and when we get back, we'll go into the capital.